math aside, this has to be some of Eminem's laziest writing to date. But appropriately enough, this song does have a lot to do with puking. It makes you feel like shit, and just when you think you're finished, surprise! But unfortunately, unlike puke, you just can't pour pink sawdust on the song to make it go away.
I'm sitting here with your name on my skin. I can't believe I went and did this stupid shit again. My next girlfriend, now her name's gotta be Kim. Shit.
This song wasn't designed for people to listen to. It was designed for him to listen to and wallow in his own sorrows. And he didn't care to actually make us feel anything.
Oh no, I feel something alright. Mainly disappointment. Eminem made a name for himself back in the day rapping about hatred, but this song just feels like a cheap callback, minus all the attitude and intensity.
Therefore I did not know that I would grow to be my mother's evil seed and do these evil deeds.
It's the first song off Encore, and much like an overture, Evil Deeds spells it all out, giving you a little taste of everything wrong with this dreadful album, all in one stage-setting piece.
This song's main problem is that it sounds like a man trying desperately to do what he did before, with bouncy, elaborately flowing, intricate lyrical delivery, but something's cracked, something's broken, and he just can't do it anymore.
Mama had a baby and it said popped off, it 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 popped off. Oh, I'm getting dropped off, getting dropped off, getting dropped off, getting dropped off, getting dropped off. Telling the next door neighbors on their front porch, their front porch.
I think you see our problem with this first verse.
Predominantly, predominantly, everything's always predominantly, predominantly white, predominantly black. Well, what about me? Where does that leave me?
With predominantly white fans in a predominantly black genre?
Well, I guess that I'm between predominantly both of them. I think if I hear that fucking word again, I'ma scream.
You're the one saying it. Who the hell's annoyed by the word predominantly? It isn't that common, and it's not nearly as annoying as moist or phlegm or slurry.
And I'd hate to have it as bad as that Mr. Mathis claims he had it.
And here he's addressing the fact that you've heard this all before and that he's recycling. But like I've always said, acknowledging that you suck is no excuse to keep sucking. In fact, now it's worse because we know that you suck and you actively aren't doing anything about it. And this is how you start off your album, by rattling off the same crap. And you know, where the other albums would joke about his conventions, there was a certain energy, quick-wittedness, and an intelligence about his self-awareness. This just sounds like he's bored, but completely unwilling to break new ground. You know, I actually liked this song when it first came out. But now that I look at it, this is the first song that signified his newer, corny style. And sure, Eminem only has one verse, but that one verse plus the stupid corny beat and the chorus are enough to pull it down. Make no mistake, the first minute and a half of this song belongs to Eminem. It's his song and it's horrible.
These chicks don't even know the name of my band, but they're all on me like they wanna hold hands. So I get off stage right, drop the mic, walk up to these hot chicks and I'm all like, "What's up, ladies? My name's Slim Shady. I'm the lead singer of D12, baby."
And while the rest of these guys are pretty much mediocre, which does nothing to hurt the song necessarily, Proof is the only one with an actually funny verse.
I'm gonna let the world know that Proof is hot. I should cut his mic off when the music starts. Ready to snap on a dumbass fan every time I hear.
Hey, dude, I love your band!
We in a band, we don't play instruments.
But then Bizarre comes in and brings it right back home.
I told you I made the beats and wrote all the raps to a con artist. Slip me some crack. Lose Yourself video, I was in the back. Superman video, I was in the back.
No, you weren't. I got some suggestions. That's just untrue. It's not even the funny kind of untrue, where there's some kind of joke to it or something. This is just lying for the sake of lying.
Fuck D12, I'm out of this band. I'm about to start a group with the real Roxanne.
Why? Why would you start a rap group with the chick from the Roxanne Wars of 1984? What is the joke here? Why was I supposed to find that funny?
I don't even think they knew what they were going for here, but the song wraps up in a neat little package, which I'm sure they thought was comedic gold.
I'm the lead singer of my band, my salsa, makes all the pretty girls want to dance my salsa. Look out for my next single, it's called My Salsa.
Why is this on the album? I think that's a fair enough question. I mean, I guess I could see who would fit in the music video, you know, for a cheap laugh. They're all in costumes, you got a cute little dog there, but I don't see anyone blasting this in their car, or better yet, singing along.
And some people have said this is supposed to be some kind of parody of My Milkshake by Khalees, which is fine, but unfortunately, that doesn't make it sound any less stupid.
Where'd everybody go?
Soldiers, I told you I'm about to blow, so look out below. Geronimo motherfuckers, it's dominoes, I'm on the roll, around and around.
Did you catch any of that? He didn't say anything there besides string a bunch of haphazard relevant words together with zero meaning behind any of them.
Eric swallowed some generic sleeping pills and woke up in bed next to his best friend Eric bare naked. Jinling just turned 16 and used a fake ID to sneak in VIP to see R. Kelly.
So? What the hell are you talking about? How do these stories relate in any way?
Am I a jerk or just jerk chicken or jerk into jerk in the chain? 22 jerks in a jerk circle, or is it a circle jerk? Wait a minute, what am I saying?
Good fucking question, M. And again, the joke here is supposed to be, oh, look how aware I am of how little sense I'm making, to which I say, okay, I don't care. You have given me no reason to care. It's just random, scattershot lyrics with no intent of telling you, the listener, anything. These are lyrics from a man who has nothing to say and doesn't give two shits of how sloppy he presents it. Did he cut any songs off this album? Did he really think this was worth releasing? Why didn't anyone stop him?
Just recently somebody just discovered Britney and Justin. Videotapes of them booking when they were just mouthing tears in the Mickey Mouse clubs. They just won, someone said no, and then tried to erase and record over it. You can hear the cut, and then they come to find out it was Justin saying I'm gonna come in this one.
Why did he just spend half a verse talking about someone discovering child porn of Justin Timberlake and Britney Spears? In such detail, no less. Why the hell would you waste this much time to tell us something that has absolutely no significance? What's the logic here? Let me try to guess. Is this fake story of child pornography being randomly sent to Source magazine that includes Justin Timberlake supposedly saying the N-word supposed to be a joke that Source magazine isn't a reliable source and that they'll just report anything? And is this story supposed to parallel the old tape they found of you saying the N-word? That's the only reasoning I can make of it, and how contrived would that be if it were true? Besides, that old tape of you saying the N-word turned out to be pretty real. So if this whole convoluted verse was supposed to be you trying to discredit them as a magazine, well, on execution alone, you failed. And I'm pretty sure it won't be the last time.
Fuck a chicken, lick a chicken, suck a chicken, beat a chicken, eat a chicken like it's a dick. Fuck a dick. Oh, suck a dick and lick a dick and eat a dick and stick a dick in your mouth. I'm done, you can fuck off. Fuck a fuck off.
So this song is supposed to be a diss track to Ray Benzino. And you know how if you're making a diss track to someone, you usually try to sound like the better, smarter, more clever person? Well, not when you're going through the infantile stage Slim Shady was going through.
You're just really jealous of me, cause I'm what you wanna be. So you just look like an idiot when you say these mean things, cause it's so easy to see. You're really just a big weenie, big weenie.
Does anybody else think this sounds like an Eminem song ran through the eyes of SpongeBob SquarePants? Big weenie, more like big pussy. What the fuck happened to you?
So yeah, with that in mind, check out some of the witty quips that no doubt put Benzino in his place.
Drooling, you have tooth decay, your mouth is open, you're disgusting. What the fuck you eat for lunch? A bunch of sweets or something? What, you munch a bunch of crunch and munch? This is on them. You look like I sound like, singing about weenies.
Shots fired?
Yeah, I guess, but who did the song hurt more? First of all, the song is whack as hell, and secondly, it's Eminem dissing somebody we really shouldn't care about in the first place. It's like when he wasted time dissing ICP on his second album. Get the fuck over it!
We're the ones who made you.
Now, I know a lot of people like this song, and it's very sentimental. Some of the lyrics are truly bittersweet.
It's funny, I remember back one year when daddy had no money. Mommy wrapped the Christmas presents up and stuck them under the tree and said some of them were from me.
But I'm sorry, I still expect some modicum of lyrical dexterity, or at least a flow that sounds like it took some time to craft. And here he sounds like he just wrote a midnight confessional and any rhyming that happened was purely coincidental.
And it seemed like everything was just starting to fall apart. Mom and dad was arguing a lot, so mama moved back on the Chalmers in the flat.
And seriously, listen to this vocal delivery and tell me it wasn't recorded at 4 a.m. in the morning.
I don't see us ever being together ever again, like we used to be when we was teenagers. But then of course everything always happens for a reason. I guess it was never meant to be, but it's just something we have no control over. And
the pure lackluster delivery murders the sentimentality of the music. Also,
now, little baby, don't you cry, everything's gonna be alright. couldn't you get anyone to do these choruses for you? I mean, it was endearing on Haley's song, but now it's getting painful.
I didn't like any of the Haley songs myself. I hate to sound unsympathetic to Eminem's plight, but I just never cared. And you know, she couldn't possibly like them either, especially when she gets older. These are like the rap equivalent to showing embarrassing baby photos to dinner guests.
We're the ones who made you.
I think we found the inspiration for that South Park episode where parents go and listen to their kids' music and it just sounds like shit noises.
An appropriate sound for this song though, because this is one of the songs off of Encore with absolutely no redeemable value. There's no main theme or point, it's just him farting around for 4 minutes, unfiltered and with no structure or purpose. His flow is as stilted as ever, and his rhymes aren't even laughably bad, because, you know, that would imply that you could actually squeeze a quantifiable amount of joyness out of this waste of studio money.
In football, the quarterback yells out, "Put, put," while he reaches in another grown man's ass. But just what if it was never meant, it was just an accident? But he tripped, fell, slipped, and his penis went in. His teeny tiny little round honey, and he didn't mean it, but his little weenie friend.
No more sarcasm, guys. I just gotta say it straight out. This is not fucking funny. It isn't offensive. It isn't controversial. It's just unacceptable.
And I ain't even gotta make no goddamn sense. I just did a whole song and I didn't say shit.
Oh! Oh! Okay, I see. That's cool. I acknowledge how pointless it was. So that just wipes the slate clean. No harm, no foul. It's completely cool. No, it's not!
Yeah, by the end of the Encore album, you will wish death on the bastard who invented the idea of self-referential humor. Now, I already reviewed this song, so honestly, I refuse to listen to it again for the purpose of reiterating my disgust for it. If you want to hear what I had to say about it, go back and check out that review. I'm serious, you talk about it. I'm not listening to that dumbass laugh again.
Oh, really? This is happening? Okay, see you in a minute. Let's see here, what do I remember about Just Lose It? I remember it not being musically, all that bad. The beat was okay. But, from what I remember, it just seemed like Eminem trying way too hard for a pop single. Like a lot of, self-referential humor, a lot of callbacks, making fun of himself. Guess he figured that would sell, and it did. But, what I remember thinking was really weird was that it wasn't like the rest of the album at all. The rest of the album was alienating as fuck. It's Eminem doing a stupid voice, making fun of irrelevant celebrities. Music video, he was wearing a lot of costumes. Michael Jackson's hair caught on fire, cause that was funny to somebody. Nose got kicked around a bit by the end of the video, and it's really all I remember. Just Lose It kind of speaks for itself.
Okay, I'm back. You're done, right?
Yep, we're good. Saved you a lot of trouble. You don't have to listen to any part of that song now.
Oh, thank God. I don't like you.
We're the ones who made you.
I ain't never seen a
ass like that.
Okay, now this song was yet another diss track, this time to triumph the insult Comic Dog. That's right, the rapper who could be contending for best rapper alive made a diss track to a puppet. This was an embarrassing time to be an Eminem fan.
But wait, that's Triumph in the video, and that's Robert Smigel's voice. So did they, like, make up or something?
Look, I don't care if the feud was real or fake. The point is, some publicity battle led to this annoying excuse for a song.
Yeah. Hey, remember those random parts about pedophilia in Just Lose It? Well, I guess Eminem thought it was so hilarious that he wrote an entire song dedicated to statutory rape.
Hillary Duff is not quite old enough, so I ain't never seen a
boy like that.
Maybe next year I'll say ass and she'll make my pee-pee go.
Doing, doing, doing.
My pee-pee.
And if that isn't enough, he's gonna piss on girls too. You know, because that's what the song was truly missing all along.
Do not treat me like a murderer. I just like to pee, pee, pee. Yes, I make R&B. I sing song and go ring it strong. Ching, chong, 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 ching.
Because R. Kelly did stuff, allegedly. And I don't know where that random bit of racism came from. It has nothing to do with Triumph the Insult Comic Dog, but it was 2004 and I guess he had to be there.
Please, please forgive, for I am Triumph the Puppet Dog. I am a mere puppet, I can get away with anything I say and do.
will love it.
So your riff on the guy behind Triumph the Insult Comic Dog is that people let him get away with saying offensive things just because he's hiding behind a puppet? Well, couldn't you make the argument that your fans are letting you get away with offensive stuff just because you hide behind the alter ego of an angry rapper? I mean, I'm still a fan, but dude, don't be a hypocrite.
I'm Triumph. Britney Spears has shoulders like a man, and I can say that and you'll laugh because that is a puppet on my hand.
How do you not see the irony in judging someone for taking cheap shots at celebrities? Have you not heard every lead single off every one of your albums?
I don't think my joke is working. I must speak weak, get to the chopper.
An Arnold Schwarzenegger reference, cause 2003 California election. You know what? Fuck it. I can't make excuses for this shit anymore.
So yeah, this song is crap. It's reprehensible and completely inexcusable as the guy who once brought us The Way I Am and Stan. But, my friends, nothing can prepare you for the number one song on this list. Nothing.
We're the ones who made you.
I would like you to imagine, if you will, someone who, in late 2005, is trying to get into Eminem's music, but doesn't quite know where to start. We've all been there. He goes to the local record shop, sees Eminem's name, but doesn't know which album to get, so he plays it safe and picks up his greatest hits album, Curtain Call. So he gladly lays his money down and runs home, so excited to pop that CD in. Now imagine you are that person, and the first track you hear, before Lose Yourself, before Stan, Sing for the Moment, even before The Real Slim Shady, the first impression you get of Eminem is a previously unreleased track called... I don't even know what to say about this. But after this song came out, people stopped saying, Eminem, please come back! And for me at least, my response was, Eminem, go away. Get lost. Don't write, don't call, leave. And never come back.
What the hell was the point of this song? The whole thing is based around a sexual activity that nobody did. He might as well have made a song about rainbow parties. Who the hell was this song supposed to even be for? It only served to highlight a gross sexual activity that people, of course, accuse homosexuals of doing because, hey, they're the demographic you can still pick on in the early 2000s without worrying about losing any money.
Shove a turbo in your ass through a tube. Shove a turbo in your ass through a tube.
Are we supposed to be singing along with this? Because... no.
This is absolute trash, with no redeeming quality whatsoever. There should have never come a day where I would take listening to an Insane Clown Posse song over an Eminem song, but this is the fucking day.
Now, some fans like to use the excuse that he was on drugs.
On drugs, my ass. Puke was made while on drugs. Rain Man was made while on drugs. The only possible excuse that a song like this can come from any being of sentient thought is that he has in mind the specific intent of eliciting pure, unadulterated disgust and hate from his listening audience. In other words, career suicide. And unfortunately for us, he managed to fuck that up too.